Jehi sansparsaja bhogaha dukkho janayo evati adyanto vantakantiyo na teshu ramate vadaha. Jehi sansparsaja bhogaha dukkho janayo evati adyanto vantakantiyo na teshu ramate vadaha. Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, we are not going to live long in this material world. Very shortly we are going to leave this material world. So we must think over and again about that eternal Tattva. Anyway, we have no scope to stay here in this material world. Nobody like to die. Who like to die? Nobody like to die. Even one mosquito don't like to die. If you fly, nobody like to die. Why? Because jivatma is eternal. There is no question of any death with that spirit, jivatma. Eternally, jivatma is not going to die, eternally always existing. That's why nobody like to die in this material world. But Prabhupada speaking, very shortly we are going to leave this material body. So, we must think over and again about the eternal Tattva so that we can get rid of this material bondage and can reach our goal. What is our goal? It depends. According to your bhajan, like in Gauriya bhajan, what is your bhajan? Everybody, those who are engaged in Gauriya bhajan, they can reach the same goal? No. That's why in Brihad Bhagavatamrita, Sanatana Goswami Pad giving comparative statement how, when, different way, there are some varieties of bhakti mode. Varieties. So, who can do what? It depends upon his own ruchi. Anyway, you can remember, I was discussing about Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, in course of this discussion I was speaking, that Dhritarashtra is blind. Dhritarashtra blind. And be sure, there is no shortage of any knowledge with Dhritarashtra. Don't think that Dhritarashtra is foolish. Dhritarashtra is not foolish. But actually, there is no shortage of knowledge with Dhritarashtra. But what's the problem then? The problem is that his blind faith, blind affection, making him blind. His blind faith, blind affection for his son, making him blind. That's why he cannot see what is what. He cannot see properly. Until and unless you are going to stand on a neutral platform, you cannot act accordingly. Until and unless you are going to stand on a neutral platform, you are not going to do any justice with anybody. Follow? Even in this material world, what to speak about the spiritual world? In this material world also, I know 100% ajivatma cannot become neutral in this material platform. But still, maybe 99%, 98% they can attend. It's possible, we have seen. We have seen from history that that king is neutral position. This way we have seen. But it is not possible for everybody to come onto this neutral platform at least. Otherwise, nirapekha na hoile dharma na jay rakshane. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is directly written by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, nirapekha na hoile dharma na jay rakshane. Until and unless you are going to stand on a neutral platform, you are not going to maintain any dharma. Any dharma? Nirapakha nahilo dharma najayarak. What you speak about Bhagavad Dharma? Why I am speaking this way? I am not speaking. Krishna already told to Arjuna, Sarva dharmanam parityajya mamekam saranam. How many dharma there? You are speaking about the sarva dharmanam parityajya sarva dharma. How many dharma there? We know one dharma, Bhagavad Dharma, but no. In this material platform, there are so many dharma. Body-related dharma, material mind-related dharma, the society in which you are put into, the samaj dharma, so many dharma. So you will have to go out of this influence first. Bhagavad Dharma, it's not so easy. About Bhagavad Dharma it is written, those who are paramahansa, only for them this Bhagavad Dharma is suitable. For us, okay, we can try. Not that we can discard. Oh no, it's written there, so I can, no, not that. Actually it is suitable for paramahansa. That's why the name of Bhagavatam is a Paramahansa Sanghita. Srimad Bhagavatam, word actually Paramahansa Sanghita. Yad Vaishnavanam Dhanam. It is not your property, is not my property. It is the property of those pure devotee, Paramahansa. Yad Vaishnavanam Dhanam. My property? No, actually, my Gurudev Paramahansa, maybe Gurudev can allow me, give me power to get that property, because a hereditary factor, father property, son can get, so I can keep hope. Another point you can remember, I was discussing, that Srimad Bhagavaji Mahapuran, somebody is speaking, Maharaj is preliminary, why should we discard about, not that. About Srimad Bhagavaji Mahapuran, it is written that it is evergreen human science. It is evergreen human science, infinity period. Not that it was effective 200 years back, Maharaj, not today, it's not happened, not that. Maharaj, it was applicable, effective that time, no. Is eternally present. Bhagavad Gita eternally present. Upanishad, Ved, Puran, all eternally present, Bhagavaji Mahapuran eternally present. But still, sometime we can see that Srimad Bhagavaji Mahapuran appear. Huh? We can see that Srimad Bhagavad Gita appear in this material world. So this kind of incident has to be there, because otherwise material people cannot grasp, digest. Material people, those who are big shastrakar, those who are writing scripture, big sadhu, they are writing that for material people, it is not possible to understand what is there in the transcendental world. For material people, it is not possible to understand graphs, the point relating to that transcendental world. Because it is totally transcendental, and this platform is totally different. Okay, sometime it is written, Sukhdev Goswami, Sutadev Goswami, Vyasadev Sandhan Singh, we are going to indicate only, direction. Like sun rises in the east. Not that the east corner going to give birth to sun, what? No, it's just direction. So this way it is written, we are going to indicate. We are going to just giving a hint, indication, nothing else. Because totally it is not possible for us to give that example which is there in transcendental world. And this much we can say, only Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the only personality in the spiritual world who can try his best to represent what is there in transcendental world in language. Try to understand what I mean. If you go through the language of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, if you are hearing, if you are reading with absorbing mood, in that case, if you can feel, if you are enjoying the full kippah of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, at least you can get the maximum, most, you know, excellency. You can get the maximum, most excellency with the writing of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, as if Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to represent this with language, which is not possible. Through language, Bhaktivinoda Thakur will have to represent want to make a screen inside my heart and see the picture. It's only for Bhaktivinoda Thakur. It's rare. So you can remember that we hear the Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran is the evergreen human science. Evergreen, it is there, present there. So, I already told you, if somebody is speaking, it is preliminary, Maharaj. Yes, I know it is preliminary. It is the background. A jivatma should make a background inside his heart on which a spiritual palace can stand. So, I know Gita is background, but still, I already told you should give full honor to Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Specially, it is spoken by Krishna as if one friend speaking to other. You can realize when some discussion going on in a meeting, some big scholar or big political leader giving lecture. But when two friends discussing with each other, the speech is more sweet and catchy. There is no ambiguity, no complicacy, but they're open heart. Friend speaking to friend, there's no complicacy. So you should pay attention that Arjuna is the topmost friend of Krishna. Topmost friend of Krishna. And Arjuna is not bonded soul. So many Siddhanta. Arjuna is not bonded soul. Yudhishthira Maharaj is not bonded soul. But still, through this incident, you know, Krishna liked to give us a lesson. Now, on behalf of the human race, total human being on this whole world, we can think that Arjuna is our representative on behalf of all the whole human race. Arjuna is representative. Also, I told you, Parikshit Maharaj is a representative on behalf of all human beings. He is putting one question. Atho prichyami sang siddhim yoginam param gurum purusha seha yat karyam miyamanasya sarvatha. His question was put. Here also we can find the actual Gita starting from the question by Arjuna. And when Arjuna putting question and Krishna giving answer, then actually Gita starting. We can think Arjuna is foolish. No, actually Krishna also speaking this way. Krishna also speaking. Huh? Kutasta kasmalam idam bhishame samupasthitam. Where from you are getting this kind of mentality? Huh? Like foolish? We can see. But one thing you should remember, through Gita, everybody can get goal according to their own wish. Like karma yogi, Dhyan yogi, Gyan yogi, Bhakti yogi. There is different kind of system through which you can get in touch with Supreme Lord. That much you can do. But regarding Rasa Tattva, I don't like to speak anything about that. Because, first of all, you should understand who are you. If you cannot understand who are you and what is your position, then how you can go ahead or back, right or left, where you can go. First of all, you will have to discover your own position. First of all, you will have to discover your own position in which you are put into. Otherwise, where you can go? North or east or up and down, where you can go? So this facility you can get through Gita. Try to discover your own position. Then you can realize what is your duty, what should you do, that you can do. Now, yesterday I already told you that sarva-dharmanam parityajya mamekam saranam braja aham tam sarva-papibhyo mokshayishami. This is a commitment, standing commitment of Krishna. Krishna speaking, don't think, I am there, I can save you. You need not play your head over any kind of dharma here, applicable in this material world. Only the thing you will have to do, you will be surrendered unto by lotus feet. Sarva dharmanam parityajya mam ekam. Ekam means only. Not that you are going to say, you are going to show your inclination unto the lotus feet of Krishna, at the same you are going to worship Ganeshji. Maharaj ki jai. Because Ganesh can give, Ganapati means leadership, can give you money, everything. So that's why this word Krishna is using. Sarva dharmanam parityajya mam ekam. Only and only you will have to come to me. Then I can save you. If you are not 100% inclined, that it's up to you what. So in this material world also we have seen, it is the advice there in Gita, say Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, and in Gita also, tad vidhi punipateno paripasneno sevaya upadekshanti te jnanam jnani nastatta darshina. Krishna also speaking in front of Arjuna, this is the system. Suppose I can see my Guru Maharaj's verse, great learned, great sadhu, realized soul, but still I cannot get realization. If I am not inclined, if I am not putting any, through seva, I am not going to put any question to find solution of my contradictory mind, in that case you are in problem. So this is a system, pranipat. Pranipat means pro means prakishto, perfectly. Pro, para, apo, onu, this kind of grammar in Sanskrit grammar is called prefix. If you use this prefix, then the power of the sound become very powerful. It's called prefix in English. So you see, ahar mean har. Har is dhatu, root. Root, you know, you've gone through grammar, I don't know. Har. So this har dhatu, if I use with a, then ahar, meaning bhojan, eating. And then if I put b plus har, then biha, traveling. Follow. Eh? Ahar, bihar, then if I put pro, then prohar means beating. This way meaning changing. Same root, dhatu same. But this prefix, if I use, then some plural. Hello? This way actually, Krishna speaking this word, that pranipat paripashnana. Paripashnana means not that I like to test my Gurudev how long, how far he is going to know. Not that. This is not the system. Pranipat means totally inclined, 100% from heart. And after that, Pariprashna means actual question, self-inquiry. Like Sanatana Goswami, Ke ami kene more jare tapotroy, iha nahi jani koisya mohit hoy. Sanatana Goswami putting question. So this is called Pranipat Pariprashna and Seva. Without Seva, if you are going to learn something from a sadhu or guru, then you cannot get anything effective. That's why Krishna Balaram was also bound to render, do some seva of Gurudev Sandipani Muni. They also. This way we'll have to do. Also, I like to give you a reminder that day I was speaking that Srimad Bhagavad Gita, you can remember that Srimad Bhagavad Gita, when that simple Brahman, one Brahman was reading Bhagavad Gita there, where? In Sirangam temple, Ranganatham temple. There he was discussing, Sirangam. That time everybody laughing because he has not gone through Sanskrit grammar, nothing, almost illiterate. But somehow, not illiterate fully, he can read something. He is having no knowledge about Sanskrit grammar or anything, but still he is reading. Everybody laughing, making a joke. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu watching that man reading Gita with full ecstasy, he is feeling some nice, Baba. Tears rolling down his cheeks, feeling some, reading Gita. In that case, one day Mahaprabhu was bound to approach that Brahman and seeking, Brahman, what kind of feeling you are getting through Gita so that you are shedding tears and everybody laughing, you never care? Everybody laughing at you, but you don't care? That Brahman with tears and eye on eyes, speaking, Prabhu, actually when I read Gita, I find that I can clearly see that Krishna is there as coachman, driver of the Rath. And Arjuna is there as a fighter, and Krishna giving total advice, nice, to Arjuna. I can see clearly. Mapu was very happy to hear. You can remember Mapu speaking, you have the right to go through Gita. They are laughing. You are reading, you cannot even read properly. Everybody laughing at you. But you don't care. But Mahaprabhu passing this remark that you have right to go through Gita. You are qualified. So, the inner meaning of this Gita, we can realize if we can find that Paramatma, Krishna is there and guiding us every fraction of a second. Try to follow what I say. If you can realize, if you can feel directly all the time that Krishna is there, guiding me all the time. This body is Rath chariot. And Jivatma is sitting there. And Krishna guiding me. This kind of direct feeling should come inside your heart. Then your reading Gita is perfect. Then your reading Gita is perfect. Otherwise, big problem. Now, you can remember that day, yesterday, I was discussing about this first Tattva, Dharma Khetre, Kuru Khetre, Samaveta Jujusavaha, Mamakaha Pandavas Chaiva, Kim Kuruvata Dhananjaya, Sanjaya. Dhananjaya, the name of Arjuna, 10 names, Saposachi, Kiriti, Arjuna, Kuntyo, so many names, 10 names. So here I already explained, I need not explain again, but one point I like to clarify, that Mamaka, this word, why is using? Because Pandava and Kaurava, they are all from the same stream. But this kind of discrimination made by Duryodhana, this kind of discrimination made by Dhritarashtra. Actually, the name Dhritarashtra, you know the meaning of Dhritarashtra, this word? You know the actual meaning of this word Dhritarashtra? You don't know. Actually, it is written explanation, Annayena Dhritam Rashtram Iti Dhritarashtra. Illegally, he is going to get control over kingdom, that's why his name is Dhritarashtra. Dhritam means catching the king. You have no right to catch, because it is the property of Pandav. Pandav gone, okay. For the time being, you are taking responsibility, then they are yet now grown up, you should hand over them. That's why his name is Dhritarashtra. He is going to catch all. But the advice of Krishna, I already started with, Jehi Sangsparsaja Bhogaha Duksha Janaya Evate Adyanta Vanta Kantiyo Nateshu Ramate Vodaha. Krishna speaking, Arjun, actually those who are really intelligent, they are never busy with sensual enjoyment. Oh Arjun, my friend, those who are really intelligent, they never try to get busy with this material and sensual enjoyment. They never go for sensual enjoyment, because they know sensual enjoyment, if you are busy with sensual enjoyment, then Mayadevi going to put you in jail. You would be put into jail. Mayadevi going to put you into jail. So sensual enjoyment, you cannot go anyhow. You cannot go to sensual enjoyment. Because jivatma is the only duty with jivatma is to do Krishna Bhajan, to serve the Supreme Lord. Jovano dhanasampatti prabhuttam avivekda ekaikam opi anarthayo kimuto yatra chatushtayam. In Niti Shastra, simple Niti Shastra, it is written, Jovanam dhanasampatti prabhuttam avivekita. One by one I can explain. Jovanam, the young age, blood is very hot. I can do anything I like. I don't care what is dharma, what is adharma, legal, illegal, don't I have power. So it is written in Niti Shastra, Jovanam, young age, people don't like to care, though I don't care. Jovanam, dhanasampatti, if you have riches, property. I'm very rich man, so who are you? That's why you can discover that Nalki were going to make great mistake of Parayan to a lotus feet of who? Naraji Maharaj. Because huge amount, he cannot count. Papa speaking, we don't like to go for huge amount of money. What we can do? Somehow we like to manage. Okay, after that we don't need. Also, it is we are leading Bhikkhuk Ashram. One day, Bhakti Gyan Bharati Maharaj laughing with me. He is sitting with me and speaking. Maharaj, you see, what Maharaj? Well, some mot, I don't like to speak his name because I'm not going to criticize it. Maharaj, Bhati Maharaj speaking, Maharaj, you see what they write in their invitation letter. What write? They say, we are not going to beg anything from anybody. You are invited here in this ashram to take prasadam. Bhati Maharaj, they are fallen soul. I mean, why Maharaj? Bhati Maharaj said, they are actually foolish number one. Because they're speaking, we never beg. Never beg means Your ashram, my base, my base. This day is a bhikkhuk ashram. We are beggar. If you say we are not going to beg, keep some money, balance in my bank, then you are fallen soul. Bhakti Maharaj speaking, Maharaj, see how they are foolish. They are speaking, we never beg anything from anybody. That means they are fallen soul. Bhakti Maharaj speaking. So anyway, we are begging. But our system is totally different. Our system is totally different, actually. So anyway, so what I wanted to speak, that sloka, sampatti, jovanam, dhanasampatti, prabhuttam, avivekita. One by one, jovanam means young age. Dhanasampatti means riches, property. Prabhuttam, the authority. I like to become the authority. Get control over whole. Prabhupada speaking, it is the topmost bondage for you. If you like to get control over somebody, then you are going to put you in trouble. Bondage. Prabhupada speaking. So, jovanam, dhanasampatti, prabhuttam, avivekita, injustice. Your mind never can understand what is proper, what is improper. Avivekita means you have not in your consciousness, that much consciousness, you can take right decision. Is right? It's wrong, Maharaj. We have seen so many people in this material world. So many people we have seen in our life. They can say, Maharaj, they are poor. Maharaj, this is not good. I should not do this way. What to do, what not to do, who can give indication? Hello. So, it is written in this sloka, jovanam dhanasampatti prabhuttam avivekita. Ekvaikam opi anarthayo kimuto yatra chatushtayam. Chatushtayam. If out of these four, if one going to touch your heart, one, four item I am speaking, na? Four item. Out of the four item, if one item going to touch your heart, and your heart going to be contaminated. You cannot leave. Anartha. Full anartha, you can grow anartha gradually. You say, fall down. Ekvaikam api anartha, kimuto yatra chatushtayam. Where four assembly there. Where four, totally four. I mean, I am now young. Jovanam dhanasampati I have. Jovanam dhanasampati. Jovanam dhanasampati prabhuttam. I am the authority. Avivegita. I have no power of, discrimination. I have no power to understand what is good, what is bad. We cannot understand. That is very dangerous. So it is written that what to speak about this four item. If one out of the four going to touch your heart, then your heart can become contaminated and you can fall down. You can remember this sloka, very nice. Jovanam dhanasampatti prabhuttam avivekita. Ekvaikam opi anarthayo kimuto yatra chatushtayam. When all the four there, and Kunti Devi, you can remember already told. Kunti Devi already told that education there. I am from high family. I have riches, good looking. Oh, then Kunti Devi is speaking. Anyway, so I am going to give you indication. That if you are busy with material enjoyment, it's material thing, then you cannot get entry in the spiritual world. It's one kind of big impediments. Now, this is the condition with Dhritarashtra. Dhritarashtra blind. If I am blind, I cannot see. I should be very humble. Maharaj, I am blind. I am handicapped. I should be very humble. I am handicapped. Somebody can help me, then I can. But what is this? Here, on the Dhritarashtra is, you know, somebody can help him. Then he can do. But still, this kind of four thing touching him. So, he become blind out of affection, blind affection for son, making him blind. Okay, blind now. So, he should not speak that way. Mama kaha, my party, my team, I mean Duryodhana Adi, and Pandavas Chaiva. Those Pandavas, what they are doing? Why? Pandavas, they are also your son. Those Pandavas, they are also your son. You should not speak that way. How you are speaking? So this way you see, on the Dhritarashtra become blind. Even when Kunti, when Draupadi sees the incarnation of, you know, Lakshmi, coming from Lakshmi, they are going to insult Draupadi in open, you know, Sabha, open assembly, Sabha. Still, Dhritarashtra not speaking anything. Dhritarashtra not speaking anything. When Draupadi Ma, Draupadi Devi, craving for justice, what is that? They want to insult me in front of you. Dhritarashtra is craving application in front of Pitama Vishwa, Karna, in front of, Dronacharya, Kipacharya. But nobody going to speak anything. Why? First point, they are, by that time, Vidur gone. So, actually, what I mean to say? So, actually, this question was putted by Draupadi. To whom? Pitama Vishwa. In Bhagavatam, I already discussed, in Purushottam Vrata, that Yudhishthira Maharaj, together with his full troops, full team, full family members, everybody, together with Krishna, they are going to the place where Pitama Vishwa is lying for Ichhamitu, wishful death. When I is that time, Pitama Vishwa was speaking so many things, detailed discussion, giving advice. Pitama Vishwa speaking lot of things, Rajniti, Dharmanditi, Samajniti, social system, Dharmaniti, everything. Where is lying? Because Krishna Bhagavan, when looking at Pitama Vishwa, Pitamaha, how you are? Then Pitama Vishwa laughing and speaking. With the sight, putting Amrita. For that time being, Pitama Vishwa not feeling any pain. All pain gone. Because Krishna, with the nectarian sight, you know, going to erase all pain. That case, Yudhishthira Maharaj one by one putting question, and Pitama Vishwa as a great teacher of this world. Why? Is the Dadas Mahajan, one of the Dadas Mahajan speaking? But when that advice, all different advice was Sri Dharma, Samaj Dharma, everything spoken by Pitama Vishwa with great energy. After that, with appealing mood, Draupadi putting question. Pitamaha, I have one question. What question, my daughter? My son? What question? Then Pitama to Pitama Viswa, Draupadi Devi speaking. You are very knowledgeable personality, you are great Pandit. But I am putting question, when they wanted to insult me in front of you, why you could not speak anything? You are speaking so knowledge now, giving so much advice, but that time where that all your knowledge gone? I was expecting that you can speak something. They want to make me naked in front of everybody. Totally injustice, but you are not speaking anything. Why? Pitama Vishwa is bound to speak with tears rolling down his cheeks. My daughter. Actually, not daughter, Pitama Vishwa. Granddaughter, actually. Usually in Bengali you speak, Batsa, this kind of word we use in Sanskrit and Bangla. Bacha. So you cannot feel this kind of. So in that case, Pitama Vishwa speaking, actually point is that those same Pitama Vishwa was there that time, and that same Pitama Vishwa now. That time I was used to take the rice of grain of Duryodhan, wicked Duryodhan, Kali. So I couldn't speak anything. I couldn't speak anything. I was trying to do speak something, but somebody stopped my, because that contaminated rice. Bishoyir anno khaile molin hoy mon. Bishoyir anno khaile molin hoy mon. Molin monete na hoy Krishna smaron. You must learn Bengali properly. Not that half learning is dangerous. When I am speaking some Bengali, oh, Maharaj criticizing. You don't understand Bengali full. Half learning dangerous, I have seen. Those foreign dude, I speak, suppose some Maharaj speaking very good. Maharaj criticizing, he don't understand. Like a one joking I told you, na? Vidyasagar, the great learned man. To him, one foreigner, that England, from England speaking. I like to learn Bengali from you. Actually, I have no time. Still, you can come that time. I can try. Yes. Learning Bengali. After some days, he is coming and dancing. Vidyasagar ji, I learned Bengali properly. I already learned Bengali. You learned Bengali? Yes. You can ask any question. Okay, Vidyasagar ji. You can speak. Jal khabar or khabar jal? Jal khabar, khabar jal. What is the difference? Jal khabar, khabar jal. It's jal khabar, khabar jal. Jal khabar, khabar. Same thing. Sahib, you go and learn Bengali. Very, very properly. You go and learn Bengali. One is drinking water. One is tiffin. Khabar jal, jal khabar. You are going tiffin. Small snack. So you cannot learn Bengali so easily. Bengali is more near to Sanskrit. Any language, how you can understand this language is rich? Any language, if you find is more near to Sanskrit, then be sure that language is rich. Hindi, Sanskrit, they're rich language because they're more near to Sanskrit. Sanskrit, topmost. But still, I am not going to put this, you know, issue in front of you, can learn Sanskrit. Then, after all, bhakti is gone, I am learning Bengali. Maharaj, you already told. I never told you to learn Sanskrit. I told to get bhakti. Foolish. You can pass judgment. Maharaj told, actually. I never told. Come and learn. Do seva and get bhakti. This much I told. You misunderstand me. At all, if you want to learn something, as I told, if I become learned man, I can become puffed up, I'm Pandit, I can insult you. What you know? I'm Pandit. This way, that much audacity can come into my heart. It's not, I'm not speaking that way. Flexible way I'm speaking, you can learn. But bhakti is must. First, whole day you should do seva. You learn. Maybe you can get some education. But if you are doing bhakti, seva, then you can find some extraordinary power growing inside you to grasp. I have seen. Through seva you are learning, there is more effective. I already told you, na? Tad viddhi panipatena padivasana sevaya upadekshanti te jnanam jnanino sattva darshana. Now this much explanation I can do, I can put in front of you, mama kaha pandavas chaiva. This one is over now. So I was speaking that how Dhritarashtra become blind. I already told there is no shortage of knowledge with Dhritarashtra. Don't think that Dhritarashtra is foolish. Dhritarashtra knowing everything. But where gone? All knowledge where gone? On the basis of knowledge, we can grow our morality, judgment can come, but that knowledge, if not going to give any, pass any judgment there inside my heart, then what use? Knowledge? No use. So here you see, I already discussed this thing, and second sloka, I like to switch over to the second sloka. And all this is spoken by Dhritarashtra, this question, I told you that Dhritarashtra is not foolish. At the same time, if Dhritarashtra is totally foolish, then how it was possible for Dhritarashtra to get back the knowledge again by the association of Biduji Maharaj? In Bhagavad Gita, I already discussed Bidur after traveling. So, when the possibility of Kurukshetra Yukta arise, and Bidurji was insulted by Durjan much before, Bidurji gone. Bidurji can see clearly they are going to fight each other, kill, gone. After Bidurji come back to help elder brother who Dhritarashtra to get back the knowledge. Then Bidurji Maharaj giving advice, I already discussed, I am giving indication. Speaking so heavily in front of Dhritarashtra. So heavily. Rajan, you should be ashamed of the fact. You are taking the rise of that Bhima. You wanted to kill Bhima through poison. You wanted to kill them. You wanted to set fire in their house. Lakha griho. Jaduk griho. You wanted to set them on fire. You send them in exile. You have done injustice. Bein sapi. Injustice you have done. Now we are going to take seva from that Panchabandha. Because Panchabandha, they are Vaishnav. They never mind. They never mind, okay. Even after Kurukshetra Yuddha was over, even after Kurukshetra Yuddha was over, all his 100 sons all gone, dead. Still then, that the question of revenge was there inside the heart of Dhritarashtra. Even, son gone, everything. Now he is now, he was put into very bad situation, miserable condition, painful situation. Still then, on the Dhritarashtra was fostering some hostility. How you know? You can remember when Kurukshetra Yuddha was over, then Dhritarashtra crying falsely. Crying falsely. Falsely crying. Oh, Bhima, you come. I am falling into the ocean of miseries. Then Bhima going to approach and give embrace to Krishna speaking, don't go. Don't go. Krishna speaking, don't go. On the contrary, one iron beam was there. Krishna speaking, give this iron beam to him. Then iron beam was put in front of him. He catch and give some pressure and iron beam was crushed into pieces. So Krishna can know everything. Krishna is sitting inside your heart. Krishna is sitting inside my heart. A super soul. Where not? Even from any dust particle, Krishna can appear if I have that much faith. Why Nrisimhadeva, I mean Krishna, came out of that pillar? It is written there in Bhagavatam, 10th September, 7th canto. It is written. What? It is written. Satyam vidhatum nijabhitta bhasitam. To prove that my servant, my sevak, my devotee never speak lie. Satyam vidhatum nijabhitta bhasitam. My devotee speak, na? Hey, that your Prabhu is there inside this pillar? Yes, yes. Humbleness, humbleness is the best missile in our life to get victory over Maya. Humbleness, when nobody knows. Everything, see, if I have some knife and fire. No! You can conquer the whole world by your humble attitude. Very humble. Follow, you see. So now, Prahladma teaching us how to lead our life very humbly. Nrisimhadeva speaking, to prove that my devotee, my servant, my sevak, never speak lie. I was bound to prove it and come out from that pillar. Same thing. Now here, Sadhu Sangha, how effective you know? Sadhu Sangha, how effective you know that Bidurji came and giving heavy treatment to whom? On the Dhritarashtra night time, lonely, in room. You should be ashamed. Your death is standing backside. Mrityu, your death is standing behind you. You cannot see. You are so blind. Then Dhritarashtra become shocked. He got back his consciousness. Really so? My age up and up. Still today I am not thinking about my future, what to do, where to go after my death. Well, well advised giving my brother, Biduji Maharaj, in his whole life giving good advice to Dhritarashtra. But that time, Dhritarashtra could not realize, day by day, moment after moment, Biduji Maharaj giving nice advice to Dhritarashtra. But Dhritarashtra was never in a position to accept that good advice. That good advice different. Compilation of all those advices. He called Vaidurikam. It is called one book. It's Vaidurikam. In his whole life, Biduji Maharaj giving different kind of advice to Dhritarashtra. He was the main minister, advisor, mantri, but he could not take because he was blind, out of blind affection was blind. Now, actually, when this question was put, what they are doing, the two teams, my party and Pandavas, what they are doing? Now, Vishwanath Chakravarti, what is this? Is actually not useless, it is actually useless question. Why? Externally you can find useless question, really so, because they are coming to fight with each other. They are coming to fight with each other, so naturally they are fighting. What they can do? Prasadam already served, everything there. If somebody can do what they are doing, they are taking prasadam, simple thing. This question is obsolete. I already discussed yesterday, the question has some inner meaning. I already told. Because the influence of the place, holy place, can affect the heart of Arjuna, Yudhishthir, Bhima. Maybe they can take decision not to fight with each other. They can take decision. This is the main thing. So many Baba, they are inside. So I don't like to go in details. This way we like to explain. It will take at least 2 hours to complete Gita. 700 So that much time, my life is also limited. That much time I cannot give. So, gist, you should catch the theme, what I am speaking. Follow, totally gist. He is also writing every day. After hearing Harikatha, what is the gist I discussed? So, Sanjay Vacho. Now, when Sanjay got the power to see everything, what is what, there, going on, there in the battlefield, and can give relay man. Who is relay man? Sanjay is a relay man. He is the son of Gobalgorisi, I already told. And now, Sanjay answering, because Dhritarashtra put a question, what they are doing. Now, Sanjay Vacho, what Sanjay watching, then Sanjay speaking. Jadrishtva tu pandava nikam budam durjadhanas tatha stada acharyam upasangyamyo raja vachanam avabrit. Avabrit means already told. Avabrit means already told. And there is one Bhagavad Gita. Here I can say that actually battlefield. So you can say Duryodhana already gone there in front of the Acharya, Dronacharya, and speaking this way. He already seeing, and then related that, that's why he is eating avabrit. So drishtva means after looking to Pandavanikam. Pandavanikam, the all the strategy of Pandavas. Strategy means all arrangement of soldiers. Different kind of arrangement they are. Very, those who are clever, they know. They know how to arrange. When I used to play football, that time also, small boy, there was strategy. Defense, somebody giving some extra facility to this defense part, somebody offense part. This is some strategy. They actually, the coachman already, actually, coach already giving advice. Those are giving 10. You should attack this way. When they can come, you should go to help him. This same thing, in battlefield also, there's some strategy. And there's, according to the strategy, if you can fight, also at the time of Second World War, General Manekshaw was the, head. When with China fighting going on, Manekshaw find there they have some extra privilege because they are coming from up. Because they are coming from that part, then Manekshaw took decision. You all first come back, then as if we are very fearful, they are coming back. All soldiers, they are coming back. After that, when the soldier already coming back, they attack from backside. Already, round. This is a strategy. This is the system. So in the battlefield also, there is so many system. So you'll have to follow strategy. Now, Duryodhan, drishtva tu pandavanikam, the strategy, the arrangement of soldiers, already shown by Duryodhana. After that, acharyam upasangyammo, lap pratyay. Here, acharyam upasangyammo. Upasangyam means after reaching. After reaching Dronacharya. Acharyam upasangyammo, raja vachanam abhavrit. Here also, big politics. Why? It's simple thing. No simple thing. No, yes, very inner meaning there. Externally you can find that actually what is there? Actually all the arrangement of soldiers already watched by Duryodhana and then gone to who? Dronacharya speaking. No, inside this word there is very inner meaning. Vishwana Chakudiva speaking, Duryodhana is number one wicked. And topmost politician has some big politics here. Why? But actually, inside Duryodhan, after watching Bhim, Arjun, Dhritarashtra, Duryodhan growing some fear inside heart. But he is very clever. Anyway, he is doing illegally. He is fighting on behalf of Adharma. And Panchavandav, they are fighting on behalf of Dharma. So if you are standing on behalf of Dharma, then you are going to enjoy some extraordinary power. Extra benefit. Because those who are in favor of Dharma, they have some extra benefit, extra power, mental power. So Dujana naturally, after watching the strategy, having some fear, secret fear inside the heart. Then, actually, Drishtatu Pandavani come, Budam, strategy, groups. There's strategy done. Dujana stada, after that, Acharya Nubhasanga, actually, Dronacharya, reaching Dhanacharya, Bachanam Idam Abhavrit Abhashata Ei Katha Bole Chilo. Speaking that way. But actually point is that he is big politician already. He is knowing something and also he wanted to He wanted to give some advice. He wanted to speak this way because he is having full knowledge that Dronacharya having some extraordinary love from Panchapandav. Really. Duryodhana already knowing that for Panchapandav, Acharya, Dronacharya having some extraordinary love. So if Dronacharya going to stop fighting because Arjuna, Bhim, Nokul, Sal, Yudhishthir, they are there. Maybe Acharya can take this, all my boys there, I love them very much, I cannot fight. Maybe I can show something, exhibition, I cannot fight from heart, it's not possible. So Duryodhana took decision, if Acharya going to take decision that way, that kind of weakness coming inside the heart of Dronacharya, I mean our Acharya, then we are going to be defeated. So I can give some medicine, very slow medicine. Potency high and externally medicine very low dose, potency high. So this way actually, so now actually speaking this way. Also have some Karsi visit is also one kind of Karsi visit because you wanted to give some honor to Acharya. In the battlefield before starting is going to give honor to Acharya, who Acharya. After that, reaching Acharya, what is the actual motive that you can find here? Actual motive what? Actually, he is speaking, O Acharya, Pasaitam Pandaputranam Acharya Mahatim Chamum Budam Drupada Putrena Tavasishena Dhimata Tava Shishena Dhimata. Pashaitam, Pashaitam. Pasho plus etam, Pashaitam. Pashaitam. Oh Acharya, look in front of you. Pandu Putranam, Pandu Putranam, Acharya Mahatim Chamum. Chamum means team, big fighting team in front of you. How strategy they are making you see. Buram. And actually, Drupada Putrena Tavasishena Dhimata. Actually, Duryodhana is very, very clever. Shoot. Politician, I told. He wanted to speak this way. Why? He wanted to give him reminder that you see, they are all your disciples. They took lesson from you. How dare they in front of you, they are standing with chest. This way to fight, they are not going to give honor to you. This way. And after all, you see, Dupado putreno dhimata. Drupada putra and Dupad Raja. Drupad Raja, who is Dupad Raja? You should know, you should have vast knowledge before hearing me. Otherwise, you cannot make any background. But Drupad Raja is the king where actually Draupadi and Dhrishtadyumna took birth from fire. From sacrifice fire, Dhrishtadyumna and who? Draupadi came out. What's the reason why this fire sacrifice was arranged? Because this Dronacharya was insulted by whom? Drupad Raja. Some incident happened. I don't like to go in details. Heavily insulted. That time, Dronacharya leaving everything and coming away, and he was posted as a teacher of Kaurava Pandava that time. After that fighting took place, problem took place, but before they together, Pandava and Kaurava, both of them. Acharya, Dronacharya was, you know, the teacher. Follow? And Kripacharya is actually Sala. Sala, you know. I mean the, suppose the you are going to marry somebody, eh? And he is the brother, he is her brother, a Sala. Brother-in-law. I use brother-in-law. So only law means jamai. Brother-in-law. So in that case, and Kripacharya was also teacher. They two. And actually point is that this the son of Drupad Raja, who? Dhrishtadyumna was bound to come in front of Dronacharya. Was bound to come in front of Dronacharya. In front of Dronacharya, actually, he was bound to come to pray him. Please, you also teach me. I like to accept you as my guru. So, he was Brahman actually. Dronacharya is Brahman, topmost Brahman. So he took decision what kind of discrimination I can put inside my heart. Okay, you can teach. But actually point is that he wanted to learn all, you know, strategy. I mean, fighting mood, how to fight. Fighting, you know, capacity he wanted to grow. After that, he wanted to fight with Dronacharya ultimately now. So actually Duryodhana is very clever. He wanted to give remind to Dronacharya so that Dronacharya can remind the previous hostility. Oh, he is the son of the Dupar Raja. I must kill him. Two, it is one kind of provocation. Provocation. It's very clever. He wanted to pinch Acharya so that he can to give him a reminder. You can remember, he is actually your topmost, you know, enemy. Now his son is in front of you, and you also teach him, and now he is standing in front of, how dare? This way, actually, Duryodhana is very clever. That's why he is speaking, are everybody speak, everybody watching, you need not give advice to Acharya. Everybody, they are standing, they are watching what is strategy. See, you need not go to Acharya to give, you know, special advice. Acharya, you can see, Pasaitvam Panduputranam Acharya Mahatim Chamum Budam Drupadaputrena Tapasishena Dhimata. You see the audacity of your disciple, you see? So, this way, actually, Duryodhana wanted to give some medicine, low dose, high power, so that become very hot and start fighting very with full power. This is the inner meaning of this sloka. After that, four to six sloka is not a big issue. AI actually is a name of some fighters, actually. Atro Sura Mahishu Asha Bhima Arjuna Samayudhi Jujudhano Viratascha Drupadascha Maharathaha. So Atro man here, Atro Sura, those are big fighter, all gather here. They are expert in, you know, fighting. Dhanurved or club fighting, Gada Yuddha or. So Atro Sura Mahishwasa Bhima Arjuna Samayudhi, big fighter they are coming, Bhima Arjuna, and Jujudhan also coming. Sattiki, his name is Sattiki, he is from actually there, from Dharuka. You can remember actually when Krishna give them opportunity. What opportunity? Morning time, who is going to meet me first? What he can ask, I can give. Krishna sleeping. First, actually, who? Duryodhan. Duryodhan coming. Duryodhan is popped up. He selected. He took decision to stand near head. But when Arjuna came, he is standing near leg. Anybody who is going to break his sleeping, going to look who is there. So look at. Then Arjuna speaking, I can pass. You can pass, but I look at him first. What to do? I can pass, believe me. Okay, you can pass, but I could not see you. What to do? Okay, what you want to ask? And what Arjuna want to ask? Arjuna, what you want, actually? Arjuna speaking, Krishna, I want nothing, only I want you. Duryodhana laughing loudly, how so foolish. I want all, in a full troops. You know, you want to, I want to get, oh, I am so powerful. Arjuna say, I want nothing, only I want you. Then both of them happy. Eh? Because he is happy in his own way. He is happy in his own way. Gone. Then fighting going to start. Now still Duryodhan having some kind of fear inside heart. Very secret. He is very clever. Though he want to cover up. He want to cover up his fear. Still it is exposed in front of Vishwanath Chakravarti and Baladev Bithabhasan. They cannot. They are very clever. They can understand this kind of mood is there. Analytical judgment. So, Atro Sura Maheshwasa Bhima Arjuna Samayudhi Jujudhano Viratascha Virat Raja Drupadascha Maharathaha Adhrishta Ketus Chekitanaha Kesi Kasi Rajascha Virjavana Dhrishta Ketu Chekitanaha Kasi Rajascha Virjavana Puru Jito Kunti Bhojascho Saibascho Narapungabaha Judhamanuscho Bekranto Ottomo Yascho Virjavano Shouhadro Draupadiascho Sarva Eva Maharathaha. Is a system 11,000 with 11,000, you know, fighter. If one is called Maharatha, that's one system there. Now you see, they are all powerful. One by one, I like to. Narapungava means hocche Narasheshto. They are all powerful. So there is a different classification. Dhrishtadyumna, I already told. Drupad, I already told. Drupad Raja, Panchalpati, Virat Raja, I already told there. At the time of exile, when Panchapandav took shelter there. And Arjuna took the base of girl to as a dance, you know, master. Of whom? Huh? Uttara. Uttara, the daughter of that king. Ultimately, Uttara, actually the son of Abhimanyu, son of Draupadi. Abhimanyu is the son of Subhadra. Subhadra, with Subhadra, actually. Subhadra is the wife of Arjuna. But Uttara is the wife of Abhimanyu. I am speaking this way, actually. I am speaking very rapidly, na? So it's very fast. So sometime. So, Dhrishtadyumna alluded to Virat Raj, you know. Virat Raj, Jujudhana alluded to Sattiki, his name. He was the coach one of Krishna, Krishna's Rath, Sattiki, or Saruti Chilen. So, he took the team, took shelter of the team of Kurukhetra Yudhe, Pandav Pakha, Asaga. No, actually, Sattiki is a beer, powerful. He is a Saruti. Saruti means?
Chariot.
Means the coach one. So, Draupadi, you already know, and Draupadi, you know, Draupadi has five sons. They already, you know, who? Ashwatthama killed them. The previous way, they are still now alive. Still I'm alive when fighting going on, not fighting started. That's why he is speaking this way. So, Panchapandav, they have five respective sons, one by one, Bhima, Arjuna. So, Bhavan, and here actually speaking, when he is speaking this way, I mean detailed discussion of who is there, who all there to fight. After they are speaking, Aspakam tu visishtaje ton nibodho dijottamo nayoka mamo sainyasya sangyartham tano bubrimi te. Te means to you for your kind information. For your kind information, I am speaking. In our team also, we have this kind of, you know, arrangement. Aspakam tu visishta. In our team also, all big, big specialists. There, asmakam tu vishishta je tannimodho mean try to hear, ho acharya. He diyottamo, nayoka mamo sainyasya sangyartham tano babrimi. Tano mana? Tano sarvano. And who their name I am going to speak in front of you now. Bhavan, first you, most powerful, and Bhismascha. You powerful, and Bhismascha, Karnascha, Karna you know, actually the son of Kunti, not known as yet, after that it was known. So, Bhavan, you, Bhismascha, Karnascha, Kripascha, Kripa I already told, brother-in-law of whom? Dronacharya, Samitinjaya, they can get victory over any kind of fighting. Whatever big it may be. Ashwatthama, you know, the son of Dronacharya. Bikarno, you know, Bikarno is the brother of Duryodhan. Bikarnascha, Somodatti, and Jayadrathaha is the son-in-law of Duryodhan. Jayadrath, actually, Dushala. Dushala is the sister of Duryodhan. And Jayadrata is a son-in-law. Anne cha bahavaho, anne cha bahavaho suraha madarthe takto jivitaha. They are all going to live their life for me. They are going to live their life in stand for me. Who care? I mean, going to give some inspiration to Acharya. Nana asto puharanaha. Sarve yuddho visharadaha. They are expert in launching different kind of weapon. Sometime club and sometime this, that. They are all, you know. So, Bhavano, Bhismascha, Karnascha, Kripascha, Samitinjayaha, Asvatthama, Vikarnascha, Soma Dattir, Jayadrataha, anne cha bahavaha suraha madarthe takt jivitaha nana sasto puharanaha sarve yuddho visharadaha bancha kalpatarvashya ke paas inde bevashya patitanang pavana bhagavashya.